Really, it's very difficult to treat a chronic arthritis conservatively. So many NSAIDs, steroids, DMRDs, all have come across. Now, these Kadila people have innovated some new molecule, which I will be just talking about it. So, as everyone knows, chronic inflammatory arthritis like rheumatism is a limitation for it, and a role of novel anti-inflammatory agents. So before knowing a drug proper, we have to know the pathogenesis, pathophysiology of a disease. As everyone knows about the rheumatoid arthritis, what is the disease, I don't think it needs any explanation. Pathophysiology. There will be a release of inflammatory cytokines from the macrophages. That's everyone knows it. That is a tumor necrotic factor, that is TNF alpha and will leads to the synovitis, production of collagenase, leads to the destruction of the extracellular matrix, and a release of MMF, that is matrix metalloprotease, which leads to cartilage destruction, degeneration, whatever it is. Arthritis also, there will be a release of TNF alpha and interleukins, which will again leads to the synovitis and articular cartilage damage. So ultimately it is an inflammatory arthritis. Cartilage or whatever, synovium. So this release of inflammatory cytokines is regulated by nuclear factor kappa B. It is called as a NFKB. This NFKB is a transcription factor present in all cells. This NFKB plays an essential role in inflammatory and immune response. NFKB acts as a master switch using spondylosis, psoriatic arthritis, and juvenile rheumatoid arthritis. So, ultimately, this NFKB is the master switch of inflammation. So, this is the activation of NFKB, how it acts and produces this cytokinases, so which translocation into nucleus, activation of genesis encoding inflammatory mediators, and the release of inflammatory mediators. So total outcome of NFKEB activation is there will be synovial membrane inflammation and proliferation of synovocytes. Panus formation will be there. There will be increased activity of COX-2 and MMPs, where there will be a destruction of cartilage and bones. There will be osteoclastogenesis and bone erosions. So, curcumin, this is a biologically active phytochemical compound obtained from rhizomes of Curcuma longa. I think it's the extract of a turmeric. Possesses diverse properties, that is anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, anti-proliferative, and anti-angiogenic. So there is a more than 65 clinical trials with more than 1000 patients completed, and there's more than 35 ongoing. NFKEB, the master switch of inflammation. So this is a multiple sites of action of curcumin, inhibiting IKB kinase, so which prevents translocation into nucleus, then prevents release of inflammatory mediators. So this is the role of curcumin in rheumatoid arthritis and osteoarthritis. So comparative study of curcumin with diclofenac was done Curcumin provided greater improvement in disease active score and ACR scores as compared to diclofenac. So 52% reduction in CRP level with curcumin. Curcumin is effective and safe in patients with active rheumatoid arthritis. So another study, 18 patients with RA were treated with curcumin for 2 weeks. Curcumin improved joint swelling, morning stiffness and walking time, which was very well tolerated with better GA tolerability. So ultimately it is effective and well tolerated in treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. So in osteoarthritis, around 820 OA patients attending outpatient clinic SCIDs and analgesics. So this therapy is very well tolerated. So it relieves pain and reduces the need of NSAIDs in OA. So there was also a comparison with ibuprofen. Same, again it showed effective as NSAIDs but better GI tolerability. So monotherapy of curcumin is effective and safe for the long-term management of osteoarthritis. So combination with diclofenac, 88 patients with primary knee OA were randomized to receive diclofenac alone or diclofenac with curcumin for 3 months. Compared to diclofenac monotherapy, combination was associated with great pain relief, better improvement in knee injury and osteoarthritis outcome scores. So ultimately, curcumin when combined with NSAIDs provides additional benefits. So combination therapy enhances action of celecoxib on COX-2, decreased need of celecoxib. With prednisolone added to anti-inflammatory action through inhibition of inflammatory cytokines, significant reduction in joint swelling, reduction in side effects due to steroids. Administration with methotrexate, synergetic antiarthritic action has been noticed. Many helps to reduce the dose of methotrexate, reduces the risk of hepatotoxicity and hematological toxicity. So ultimately it is safe, is generally recognized as safe. No noticeable adverse effects were observed with the doses up to 8 grams daily for 3 months. Unlike NSAIDs, free from adverse effects of curcumin. This conventional curcumin has some limitations where poorly water-soluble polyphenolic compound poorly absorbed from GI tract, undetectable in plasma, doesn't reach system. Curcumin have used high doses up to 12 grams per day. Few studies have not shown positive results, poor GI tolerability. So this needed a bioavailable, effective and well-tolerated curcumin formulation. So this bio-enhanced curcumin, which is self-micro-emulsifying drug delivery system, has been developed. So which is a nano-sized hydrophilic droplets of curcumin. Improved absorption enhanced curcumin ensures high bioavailability. So this bio-enhanced, like biologics, can be given orally in safe and well tolerated. Suitable option for monotherapy as well as combination therapy. So an attractive option in the management of RA and OA, either as mono or combination therapy. Particularly useful option in foreign groups of patients intolerant to NSAIDs and steroids or DMARDs, compromised renal function, hepatic dysfunction, CV disorders, hypertension, and CHF.